The Malaysian pair then being introduced. Kien Keat and Tan Boon Heong.
Naoki, Kawamae, Shoji,
and Sato and Kawamae also being introduced. Kien Keat and Tan Boon Heong. Ku at the front, Tan at the back. Ku with a little stumble. Hope that's not a shape of things to come as he enters the court. It's a partnership that's had some great moments. It's also a partnership that sometimes flatters to deceive. What sort of partnership are we going to see here at these London 2012 Olympics? Are we going to see an irresistible Ku and Tan, or are we going to see a fragile one? This is a very tough group. This is Group D. As I say, doing the usual preliminaries here. Toss of the coin, see who serves first, see who's going to go which end. But what a group we've got here, because not only have we got these four players here, potential gold medalist winners in Chung Jae-sung and Lee Yong-dae of Korea, former world champions, the American pair of Howard Back and Tony Gunawan. Some calling this the group of death. And there's no doubt who the outsiders are. It's the Japanese pair of Sato and Kawamae. Well, you may see some power from this man. They are getting revved up already. Tan Boon Boom Heong. 421 kilometers per hour. Whatever you want to translate that into, it's fast, it's hard, and it's unstoppable. And when he's at his very best and he's really revved up, he is the quiet, laid-back one. Ku at the other end, who I have to say looks as if he's lost quite a bit of weight and looks in pretty good shape. He is the extrovert, the flamboyant one of the Malaysian pair. There he is. You may see the odd kind of trick shot, the odd unexpected shot. He is fantastic to watch, but as a playing partner I would assume that sometimes he can be a little frustrating. So much talent, of that there can be no doubt. But it's been a pretty torrid year so far for Ku and Tan. There is Tan Boon Heong, the fastest smash in the fastest racket sport. He is the world record holder at 421 kilometers per hour. Only won once this year. That was the Malaysian Open Grand Prix gold event, which they do it in ranks. So the top event will be like an Olympics. They won the Commonwealth gold before, but they have won only a Grand Prix gold event. You have Super Series events. They're the top general events that you have outside of the majors. I'm talking about the majors, like the Asian Badminton Championship, the World Championships, and of course the Olympics. Naoki Kawamae, 29-year-old, like his playing partner, making his Olympic debut. And I said that Ku and Tan haven't been in the greatest of form. Well, this pair haven't either. Well, ranked number 13 in their last two events, beaten in the first round in Indonesia, beaten in the second round in Singapore. They've also won a Grand Prix event this year. They won the Swiss Open in March. But the All England Championship and other of the big events that's played in Birmingham, in the Midlands in England. They lost in the first round of that. And they were also beaten on early on here in the World Championships to Kai and Fu, who are the favourites for the gold medal. Now it's going to be really important for their mental state how Ku and Tan start here. Their coach Pang Che Chang says they have every chance of making the quarterfinal stage as long as they don't freeze. He's worried about their mental state. I suppose Sato and Kawamae will know that. They'll know that this is a chance. If they can get off fast, maybe they can just unsettle Ku and Tan here. The umpire just about ready to get us underway here. Sean Hee-joo of Korea. Lim Mond of America is our service judge. Start us here. Ku and Tian. What are they going to serve up for us here? Former world number one pair, seemingly on the slide. And maybe their last ever tournament together as a pair. And, well, I told you they can be brilliant. And we saw the positive side of them there in the first point. They have got every shot available to them. Can they stay disciplined enough? Japanese off the mark. Well, Ku doesn't hit quite as hard as Tan, but he mopped that one up pretty well. Good reach, good angle. See here from men's doubles that exchanges can be very fast and furious. Excellent play. Kawamae there, close to the net. Dispatching that one nicely. In misjudgment. And the Japanese pair ahead here now. Well, they have the potential, there's no doubt about it, Ku and Tan, to challenge the gold medal, never mind get through to the quarterfinals. They're the first Malaysians to win gold at the Asian Games in 36 years. They won the Commonwealth Games gold medal as well in 2010. They've been world number one. They're also a pair that have come in for quite a bit of criticism. They certainly can be a talking point. Not always getting on. I suppose you haven't got to always get on with your partner, but I was taught they weren't even on speaking terms when they won gold at the 2006 Asian Games. They've been together now a long time. And this is their chance to maybe, if they are to split up after this, to go out with a bang. 3 points in a row, turn it around in their advantage now. 6-4. Sato trying to break down this Malaysian defence. Clash of rackets, they got away with it there, Kuantan. Well, that's an excellent touch from Sato at the net. And they need to get on the front foot quicker, the Malaysians there. It was all a little too much on the back foot. They can't just keep playing defensive shots. They somehow got to turn it around. Otherwise, these two, Kawamae and Sato, are much too good for that. Attempt to reach it from Kawamae, who's flat out on his stomach. Probably have to mop up the court a little here. A little bit of sweat on the court makes it quite slippery and dangerous. Yeah, everything seems to be okay. Great angle found by Ku there. Opportunity perhaps there from the Japanese pair into the net. The interval advantage for Kuantan, 11 points to 6. Yeah, they'll be pretty pleased with their work so far. And pushed on in the last part of that opening exchanges here. Been pretty disciplined, certainly haven't frozen, as was the worry for Bang Jiejiang. You look at the opponents they've got to face here, Kuantan and Kawamae and Sato are the pair that they really have to beat. Japanese haven't been in the greatest of form, as I've pointed out. But then again, neither of the Malaysians, I suppose. Enjoying that Tan and Koo, and why not? One title this year, one title last year. Shot through the legs there, Kawamae. Didn't quite come off though. This has been quite a comfortable workout so far for Koo and Tan. Themselves back into this match. That's a huge board in Malaysia. And as badminton, there's been an offer actually from somebody with a gold medal bar. I say gold medal, it's just a gold bar. It's worth something like $630,000, and it's on offer to any Malaysian or Malaysian pair that managed to win a gold medal. Of course, they've never won a gold out of Malaysia at the Olympic Games. And of course, badminton, they're a real big chance with Lee Chong Wei in the men's singles. Come close, one silver. Don't think there's going to be any doubts about the outcome of that point once it was lifted up like that, short. Six now the advantage. It's a big gulf right now between these players. From Koo. And a precious point won by Sato and Kawamae. They've got to keep focused here, Koo and Tan. Not offer too much encouragement, but credit to Sato and Kawamae, picked up a couple of points. That's brilliant. That's what we expect from Tan. A little bit of power at the back of the court, but not just the power, was it? It was the angle and the placement from him. Is there on the Japanese bench, and you can understand why. Match we saw in this quarter, a mixed doubles game. The dominant pair in the first game were swept aside in the second, although they went on to win. Kawamae and Sato, though, it's hard to see them, isn't it, turning this one around in the second. Koo and Tan have been pretty comfortable in this opening game. Should have gobbled that one up though, Coop. Boosting points here at the end of this first game for the Japanese. That's well placed to the back of the court. And it brings up game points then for Kuantan. 9 of them. Front of the court, Tan at the back. They just swap positions there momentarily. And they won't allow Kawamae and Sato to get on the front foot. A little struggle for these Japanese players here. And you're short of confidence like they are. You come to the Olympics, you're up against some really strong pairs, and Kuantan certainly come into that category. 21-12, they've taken this opening game here in the opening match in Group D. Look, I'm talking terms now. Kuantan, and they are looking very focused, aren't they? Very disciplined first game. I mentioned the extrovert Ku, and likes to play a few shots, which some would say the purist, that aren't always played at the right time, but didn't see any of that in that opening game. Say, from my own perspective here, it's difficult to see Sato and Kawamae turning it around. You can see the Malaysian fans there in their tops here to support their players. Obviously disappointed to see the mixed doubles pair of Go and Chan lose in the previous match on this court, but every chance there's going to be some Malaysian success here, unless somehow Sato and Kawamae can really step it up in this second game. Counting down to the start of the second game. And it took 15 minutes for Kuantan to win that opening one, 21-12. It's a case of keeping it simple, you think, here for Kuantan. Get on the front foot as much as they can, and they should win this one pretty comfortably. And already both Japanese players there stuck at the back of the court, and somehow they've got to get themselves in offensive positions. It's not easy. It really isn't. Even when they did that, the skills of Kuantan were able to get them out of a little hole. It can be so demoralizing. Well, they're off the mark at least. Sato and Kawamae. There's a real sense of inevitability about this match, isn't there? There has been ever since we crept towards the first interval. And Tan. Well played by Sato there. Yeah, in tournaments like Kawamae and Sato, who have, of course, Indian Open last year, Swiss Open this year, you've got to have something about you. Good, it was in. So, just to remind you, four pairs in each group. This is Group D, D for Group of Deaths, I'm suggesting. It is a very high caliber group, but they are throughout. The top two pairs from each group will go through. They will, of course, play one another. I suppose the favourites to go through from Group D will be Chung Jai Sung, Lee Yong Dae, and this Malaysian pair. But you know, you've got four world champions of Howard back and Tony Gunawan in it. Not easy to predict. This was certainly a must win game for Ku and Tan. As I've said already, the Japanese pair very much the outsiders. There are no marks, as you can see from some of the badminton they are producing. Outsiders in terms of the quality in this group. Sato there, and these are unforced areas, something they can't afford. You can see a little, if you maybe saw it, hand signals there from Tan to Ku. It was to show his partner where he was going to serve towards. Well, didn't help, he was given as a service fault there by the service judge, Lin Mond. Easy pickings. No, well, maybe look easy at least, Ku. He's a very natural looking badminton player. And these two are one of my favourite pairs to watch, I have to say. You never know what you're going to get, though. I think they're not too sure they're going to give either. That's excellent. Excellent shot from Sato. Lovely disguise at the back of the court. Malaysians expecting the smash, went for the little drop. And digging deep here, Sato and Kawamae trying to push Ku and Tan as much as they can. So one more point to take a lead into the interval here for Malaysian. Two some of Kuantan. Good attacking play from the Japanese, but the Malaysians have turned it around brilliantly. That's an excellent point, one for Kuantan. And their fans certainly enjoyed it. 11-8 the interval lead. Said, I think, to Kuantan here. I think they got this one sussed out. Just have to get rid of those unforced errors, the Japanese pair. It's been hard work for them. They're just kind of trying to hang in the match here. You see Kuantan on court ready. They're raring to go already. And there you can see the umpire, Shonhi Ju, just telling the Japanese players to get themselves out there. They're running around, working hard. And the Malaysian pair make it looking pretty easy. It's a lot of running around here for Kawamae and Sato. Umpire saying that, the box not tidy enough. He wants to change the shuttle. Asia have dominated the medals since the sport entered the Olympics in 92. 69 of the 76 medals available have been won from countries from Asia. Seen any of the tan boom, have we yet? Get closer to the line, we might just see them have a big dig. Here we go, tan at the back here. No, it's, I would say, mediocre stuff from him so far. Had the chance there, Sato, to maybe put a few red faces on the Malaysian pair, but not to be. Two of the 3 points since the intervals have been won by Naoki. The luck of the net call there as well. Brilliant from Koo. The Japanese players were expecting to go cross-court, just a drop shot down the line, and they were left flat-footed. And now it's a healthy lead in the second game as well for Kuantan here. Thank you. very interesting watching Kuen Tan here. They're looking very, how can I put it, efficient, disciplined. And I think that will please their coaches, you know. Of course, they're going to have to open up, and they are to progress in this Olympics. They're going to have to play some big shots, use their power, but they're easing their way into this tournament nicely. They look at each other in bemusement there as Sato's little drop shot leaves them bemused, rather Kawamae's little drop shot leaves them bemused. Inspiration in the face here of Naoki Kawamae. Olympic debut for both of these Japanese players, and they've been given a real test, haven't they? Excellent rally. Into the net. And Malaysian flags are flying in Wembley Arena. 3 points now from victory. Wondering where Wembley is. Of course, it's famous for its football stadium, which is adjacent here to Wembley Arena in the northwest of London. Quite a way for the athletes to travel from Wembley to the Olympic Village. Some are staying locally. Some are making their way to the east of London, to Stratford, where the athletes' village is. There are special Olympic lanes for the athletes, so they can be driven in a special lane where no other local can travel. Wide from Tan, but they can look at each other with smiles. Tan and Kua, I think they know this one's done. A little bit of focus, and they should mop off these 3 points without any worries. And there's one of them. Well, there are tough days to come for Kua and Tan. They have not really had a tough run here. Kawamae and Sato have been outgunned by the Malaysian pair. And it's now match points. Well, they had a 3-0 record against the Japanese. They beat them in England at the All England, the oldest badminton tournament, started in the 19th century, would you believe? Is that it? Not quite. One match point saved. Six more to go. Ku and Tan are off and running. The Malaysian pair have made it look pretty easy against Sato and Kawamae. Disciplined, efficient, and a very good performance by a pair who can be absolutely brilliant Monday and pretty torrid the next, but we've seen the better side of them here, and they're off to the start they wanted here in Group D. Now can they keep it going and get to the quarterfinals? Minutes is all it took them here to win 21-12, 21-14.